This was during a meeting held between members of the Parliamentary Forum on Road Safety and a civil society group called Centre for Policy Analysis at Parliament, where legislators decried the failure by key stakeholders to understand and prioritise road safety in Uganda.
We are trying to see how we can lobby and advocate increase on the budget for road safety, how we can position ourselves and identify ourselves to be the champions of promoting and increasing the budget for road safety, and the problems that are there that we know, which is related with the low financing.
Even the little you said was allocated, can we confirm that it actually did the work? Because there are times Parliament sits, appropriates, but the actual releases do not go to the components that were allocated.
Whatever is proposed to fund this particular initiative should actually be considered 100%. The arguments on why we should fund is self-explanatory. It is known.
The development comes at a time the annual crime report by Uganda Police Force indicates a 42% increase in the number of crashes from 12,249 in 2020 to 17,443 in 2021. Lawmakers wondered why Uganda relies on road transport as the only means of transport on land, yet the roads are poorly designed and pedestrian crossings neglected.
All the new roads that we are going to must take care of these things that we are discussing now. There is no point for us to borrow money and the road is constructed for only vehicles and not the pedestrians.
They called for investment in public transport so as to reduce the number of vehicles in the country and ensure safe movement of people across the country. MPs propose intervention like road marking, providing walkways on all roads, emergency services on highways, and beefing up deployment of traffic officers.
All the other countries that have succeeded in reducing the numbers of road traffic crashes have actually invested in infrastructure that is required. For instance, investing money in public transport.
MPs also believe road safety cannot be discussed without highlighting education.
There's need for the engineers having the same road safety precautions while designing. Like you said, everyone has become a designer. Some people are in narrow, others are Minister of Finance, others are aware. All of them are working on roads, but are we doing the same thing? Do we have a standard?
The meeting resolved that the forum meets President Yoweri Museveni and engage him on the need to treat road accidents as any other epidemic he has fought by providing adequate resources.
We want to call upon the president to look at how do we continue to lose 4,000 people every year, even more than what COVID-19 killed in 2 years. The road crisis is becoming number two or number three behind HIV, AIDS and malaria.
According to the chairperson of the forum, Tony Ayo, they have resolved to push for reforms in traffic rules to see traffic rules and penalties heightened and have reckless drivers who cause fatalities on roads charged with murder cases.
If somebody knocks you dead, we call it accident. And what do we do? You meet the burial expenses and small compensation. But when you make comparison with other countries like US, you knock somebody dead, you go in prison for 40 years.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.